Hello everyone. In this video, we'll look at EMS test. EMS test is a test used to determine the mutagenic potential of an unknown chemical. And it is still used today to determine mutagenic potential. It was developed by Bruce EMS. Bruce EMS developed this technique in UC Berkeley, and it is very simple yet elegant technique that is still used today. Now let's look at the technique. The whole principle of this technique is based on the capacity of a chemical to revert a mutation in the his operon of a mutated strain of Salmonella typhimurium. This mutated strain of Salmonella typhimurium is known as a tester strain, where the histidine operon, simply the mechanism which synthesizes histidine, is mutated. As a result, this strain cannot make histidine, and this strain is very commonly known as a tester strain. It has many other mutations as well, but in the histidine operon, it has point mutations and frameshift mutations. Now, obviously, as there are frameshift and point mutation in the histidine operon, it cannot be expressed. The genes cannot be expressed and histidine cannot be synthesized. As a result, you need to supplement histidine in the media. Otherwise, these bacteria won't even grow. Now, here comes the trick. So, you need to put your chemical of interest in a culture of this tester strain. Now, if this chemical is mutagenic, then it would be at least be able to revert the mutation in the histidine operon for some of these bacteria, right? And in those strains, the histidine operon would be functional again. So what we simply would observe is reversal of the histidine operon mutation. As a result, histidine operon would be turned on, histidine would be synthesized, and the bacteria can grow again. Simply meaning, if we see more colonies in the plate, then that particular chemical is highly mutagenic. As a result, it gives rise to revertants, and that is why we are seeing a lot of colonies. In contrast to chemical A, if we talk about this chemical C, we cannot see colonies in the plate. That means this chemical was not able to reverse the effect of the mutation in the histidine gene. And that is why histidine cannot be synthesized by those bacteria and they eventually die. Compared to these two, we can see in the chemical B, it is moderately mutagenic, because we can see quite a few colonies compared to chemical A, but it's more than chemical C, right? So it's a moderately mutagenic compound. So it is very good test for a first pass screening of a mutagenic potential of a particular chemical. Now let's talk about the advantage and disadvantage. So obviously this technique is simple enough. It is doable, cost effective, and it is very fast, right? But the disadvantage lies, it cannot be tested for chemicals which could be a pro-mutagen. So what is a pro-mutagen? So pro-mutagen is a substance which directly don't work on the DNA and cause mutation, but they get eventually converted to a mutagenic format, and that happens inside the body. So obviously that is why we cannot use this particular technique to determine the effect of a pro-mutagen, right? Other than that, this technique is very, very useful to determine the mutagenic capacity of a chemical. So I hope you enjoyed this video. These kind of videos are very important for CSIR Unit 13, IIT JAM, GATE, JNU CEB, GATB 2020. So if you like this video, give it a quick thumbs up. Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe, and do hit the bell icon for notification. And you can also follow me in Unacademy, which is India's biggest learning platform. You can use my code AP10 for 10% discount. So see you guys, and do let me know in the comment how you like my videos. Thank you.